Hardest place, according to the Wharton School of Business, is published in the Wall Street Journal, the longest permit times in America, the metro New York region, the third longest permit times in San Francisco Bay region, and right in the middle of that is Providence Metro, Rhode Island. Over time, we've come to accept the process that's evolved. It's lengthened a lot of these permits. At every step of the way, it's gotten a little bit bigger and longer, and that's just kind of how we are today. I think there's some areas here in this bill we'd like to address that would tighten that up a little bit that aren't specifically covered by statute. Mr. Bradley would go through a lot of the exact data and the specifics, but I can tell you from someone who has to go before these boards, what my clients never understand is the minute they go before their planning and zoning board, they think they've gotten a decision that night and they're ready to go. But the time between the night of the decision, the typing of the letter, the signing of the letter by the chair of the zoning board, which is a condition that seems to have evolved and nobody's aware for sure why, to the time when the decision is functionally recorded with a 20-day appeals period starts by state statute, sometimes that can be many months long, just because of, this is one example Mr. Bradley talked about. This is an example of what many of the state agencies have worked into of leading things out and becoming more efficient. DEM being a really good leader in that. Janet Coit, Director Coit, took a hard look at this and figured out what's the actual amount of time to get these things done. Wetlands permits are 86 days. It's really about a week worth of work. How can we get the staff to be reorganized and more efficient? That's essentially what a lot of this is going to come with Mr. Bradley. I'd be happy to take any questions.
Are there any questions, Mr. Caldwell?